Today is a national day to protest police brutality. Rallies are happening around the country, and there was one in Greenville today. Victims, families, supporters, and activists came out to head to the solicitor's office to demand change. And 7 News reporter Kimberly Brown was there during that protest today. Kim joins us with more on that. Kim, what happened?
Well, Gordon, this afternoon, they basically wanted to go to the solicitor's office to have audience with him. This afternoon or evening, about 6:30, a rally is actually scheduled for the public to come out to protest police brutality. And so it's going to happen right here in front of the Greenville County Courthouse. That's where they're scheduled to meet at 6:30. You know, viral videos brought things out in the open, the awareness of how police officers interact with the public, with everyone seemingly having a camera in their pockets. Sometimes the perception and the solutions aren't always on the same page.
And we're here on behalf of all the victims that have been murdered in the state of South Carolina by law enforcement.
For Candace Brewer, national stories about police brutality and citizens getting shot at the hands of police hits close to home. She says her uncle, Charles Roseman Sr., was killed by deputies in 2015.
For them to go in his home and murder him when he needed help, yeah, we're going to seek justice for him. Not only for him, but for all the stolen lives.
It's a thought and a level of pain she lives with every day. That's the reason for Monday's rally in Greenville. Organizers say they want change.
This is a list of our demands that we have.
This group wants, among other things, transparency, officer training, and nationwide background checks for officers. Activist Afia Wangaza, director of the Malcolm X Center, has been fighting for justice for decades. These survivors are giving voice to those who can no longer speak.
We demand that they be held accountable, that cops who kill people are prosecuted.
After nearly a decade as an officer and now the president of the Fraternal Order of Police, this former officer says law enforcement works hard to protect and serve.
Every day we want to go in. We want to do our job. We want to protect the public. We want to keep the public safe. But our primary goal is we want to go home.
And for those fighting for reform, they want their loved ones to come home too.
We want the officers to be held accountable because they're killing unarmed black men.
The Stop Police Brutality rally, again, set for 6:30 this evening right here in front of the courthouse in downtown Greenville. Reporting from downtown Greenville, I'm Kimberly Brown, 7 News.
Yeah, Kim, a couple of things. First of all, that Roseman case that you mentioned in your story, a deputy was shot in the head that night. So there are two sides to some of these stories. I wonder how many people are they expecting to show up for this rally?
Well, we spoke with law enforcement. They aren't expecting a large crowd, but no doubt those who show up are passionate and they come with heartfelt desire to see change, because knowing that sometimes there are two sides to every story, they want all sides heard. They want police trained, but they also want citizens trained so that they know how to interact with one another. Gordon?
All right, we will wait and see how that rally develops. Kimberly Brown, thank you.